Swapping out the front sprocket in your Bosch Performance Line or Performance Line CX motor is a quick, easy, and relatively inexpensive way of tuning your bike or optimizing it for the type of terrain that you ride in. In today's video, we're going to show you just how to do this. Right, first up, let's have a look at two typical scenarios of front sprocket and cassette setup on different e-bikes. This is a high bike Enduro 8. It's got a 16 tooth front sprocket on it and 1142 cassette on the rear. Now you need to bear in mind that some bikes actually come with an anti-suck device on the front sprocket, which means it limits the size of chainring you can fit to the front. So this bike is a high bike Enduro 10 and it's got quite a different setup in terms of gearing to the previous bike. It too has a 16 tooth front sprocket, but on the rear is 11 to 48 cassette, which means it can get up a lot steeper hills than the previous high bike 8. Now we've got a range of front sprockets here from 14 to 22, which are compatible with the Bosch system. Let's get into it straight away. Now the first thing that you must do, this is really essential, is you must take out your battery before attempting any work on the motor area. Now, removing the front sprocket on your e-bike is super simple. You just need three tools to do this. You need an 8mm to remove the crank, half inch drive, which you add on the lock ring removing tool. Now, the first job to do after, of course, removing your battery, I can't emphasize enough how important that is to take the cranks off. Now, some bikes come with a self-extracting crank nut, and you'll know the difference because the ones that are self-extracting have a 10mm outside and an 8mm inside. So very simply, just undo that anti-clockwise. Now I've got a specialist Bosch lock ring tool here. If you haven't got one, just simply take your bike into a Bosch dealer and it's a 10-minute job. So very simply, you take the lock ring off. Now it's very simple, but remember it's a left-hand thread on this lock ring, so you need to turn it clockwise to loosen it and anti-clockwise to tighten it. At this point, you need to take up the slack in your chain by moving your derailleur forwards. Now remember that some derailleurs have a clutch on them, which means it will lock out, like so. And all you do is pop that off there. So you have your front sprocket out. Now at this point, it's worth explaining it. There are different types of front sprocket on e-bike motors. Now, this is a high bike brand specific front sprocket and it comes with a double bash guard nut, both on the inside and the outside. You can get other versions which are bash guard on the outside only, or some aftermarket sprockets which come by themselves, in which case you'll need to buy a bash guard to go with that. Now, as I mentioned earlier, there are a range of sprockets available for your Bosch motor from 14 teeth up to 22. Now, the type you choose depends on the type of terrain that you're riding. So a small sprocket from about 14 to 16, that's gonna be way more suitable for mountain biking in hilly terrain. However, a 22 tooth front sprocket is gonna be far more suitable for flat terrain. But bear in mind that your e-bike has got a 25 kilometer an hour restrictor on it, so you're going to be hitting that pretty quickly with a 22 tooth front sprocket. So a 14 to 16 is a far more practical sprocket to use on a mountain bike. Now, before fitting your front sprocket, bear in mind there's a right way and a wrong way to fit it to your bottom bracket. So some of these sprockets might be stepped, in which case that affects the chain line, whereas others are quite flat, so they go on one way or the other. Now, I'm just about to put the front sprocket onto the motor. On this particular sprocket, the righting is on the outside. And just about as I'm putting it on, bear in mind there's a rubber O-ring on the bottom bracket. You need to be careful you don't damage that when you're mounting the sprocket. Next up, the chain guard gets mounted. Remember, it's anti-clockwise on this. Okay, so now I'm tightening the bash guard and I'm tightening it anti-clockwise. Simple as that. 20 newton meters, as you'll find on the guard. Job done. Pop the chain on, loosen off the derailleur, and stick the crank back on. And remember to get them opposite. This is clockwise. So there you go, swapping out a front sprocket on your Bosch motor, a very quick and easy job indeed. Don't forget to put your battery back in, otherwise you'll be going nowhere. And there you go, you'll be away. Now, it's worth noting why I actually put a 14 or 15 tooth sprocket on this bike. And that's because the small sprocket will increase my range, especially when I'm in the mountains. It'll enable me to go up far steeper hills than say a 16, 18 or 20. But there's another side to that story as well, because if you've got a smaller sprocket up front, it's going to mean that you're going to be able to spin lower gears, which is going to mean that you can ride the bike in eco mode rather than turbo or trail mode, which is going to save your battery considerably. So there you go. Hope you like this video. If you want to see motor-related features, there's a motor feature down here. Give us a thumbs up if you like this video, and please do leave us your comments below, because I'm sure there's going to be lots of them regarding gearing on e-bikes. And yeah, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you've not already done so.